Hey everybody, I'm Delicia, and thanks for tuning in to my weekly top 5 cigar picks. These are the cigars I've been smoking this week. Hopefully they're making their way into your humidors for your week of smoking. Starting out with number 5, it's this beautiful Maduro that I'm smoking here. This is the Villiger Maduro Sandoro. It's a Brazilian, it's actually a Brazilian puro, so mata fina on the wrapper. You're gonna get the nice notes of dried cherry, you get a little bit of a dark roast coffee, subtle sweetness kind of throughout the entire stick, not a lot of spiciness, but you do pick up a little hint of cinnamon, more so on the retrohale, but really a nice smoke overall. Again, Villiger Sandoro, the Maduro, they do have, I believe, 3 different ones, possibly a 4th if I'm remembering correctly. It's been a little while. I've kind of taken a break from this particular line and found them again in the humidor, but I know they have a Claro, they have the Colorado, and then they have a Maduro, and I want to say there's another one, but let's stick with 3 for now, and I'll get back to you guys on that one. Going on to number 4, we have a beautiful Nicaraguan puro. This is the Mombacho Liga Maestro, and this one is, as I mentioned, a Nicaraguan puro. It's featuring a Jalapa wrapper, binder, from Condega, and then the fillers are from Jalapa and Condega. Medium to full body, you get nice notes of cedar, coffee, black pepper. It's a fairly earthy cigar. It's coming straight out of the beautiful Mombacho factory in Granada, Nicaragua. It's a wonderful factory to visit if you have the opportunity and you're vacationing perhaps in Granada. It's a beautiful, beautiful place to see how they make their cigars and also just to hang out and have a nice smoke. Moving along to number 3, we have the Cimarron. This one is by El Artista. This is coming straight out of the Dominican Republic. There's 2 different wrappers. This one is the Maduro. So this one is featuring a Mexican San Andres wrapper, Negrito binder, and then Colombian and US on the filler. So with this one, you're getting a perfect combination of sweet and spicy. That's the best way to describe this one. You have those nice kind of subtle sweet mixtures of the traditional Mexican San Andres flavors that we pick up from a lot of different cigars. They have that nice subtle sweetness, cocoa, kind of like that raw cacao bean, and then you have a little bit of that spiciness of the cinnamon element. Once in a while you pick up more of the pepper versus the cinnamon, but really it's just a great combination of sweet and spicy. Love the price point on this one, by the way. It's right at that $7, $7 and change, depending on what size, where you buy it from. It is available in 3 different sizes, but a really nice price point for a very flavorful smoke. Again, the Cimarron from El Artista. Moving along to number 2, we have the Black Chazaro. This is a great stick. Also, using the Mexican San Andres, but this time all the way throughout the stick. So this is a Mexican puro. Not a lot of these, in fact, I don't want to say there's not any others, but not that I am very familiar with. There's not a lot of people that are making straight cigars, making, you know, using only Mexican tobacco. So this one, again, using a very flavorful Mexican San Andres. They have a very special aging technique that they use, so a minimum of 5 years on the aging for the wrapper on this one. It's also being fermented with coffee and like a high-end rum and some other stuff that they don't disclose, but it's just a really nice amount of flavor that you get from this. And despite the dark color of the wrapper, it's definitely, it's almost a lighter bodied. It's not, I guess I wouldn't say mild, but it's definitely not a super strong cigar by any means. It's barely a medium. I would put it right in the mild, the heavier end of mild, but just getting into medium as far as body. Great cigar, whether you're new to smoking or you're just an avid smoker and you want something with a lot of flavor that's not gonna overpower you on the strength. This is a fantastic cigar, especially with your morning cup of coffee. Or if I did do a video recently, it's a pairing video where I showed you guys how to make a Carajillo cocktail. So it's an espresso-based cocktail. And paired with this cigar, it's phenomenal. So if you get the opportunity to treat yourself to that pairing, I highly recommend it. Again, you can check out that pairing video as well, but a great, great flavorful cigar. Which brings me to number 1. So this little baby, yes, I'm using it again. This is the Highclere Castle. This was my number one cigar of the year. Great cigar. This time I'm featuring it in the Petite Corona. My new favorite size to smoke of this cigar. A lot of flavor. It's a true medium-bodied stick. So perfect, again, for pretty much any level of smokers out there. It has a beautiful, beautiful Connecticut wrapper. It's over a Criollo and Corojo from Jalapa and Ometepe on the filler, and then and also an exclusive hybrid Nicodan that's again on the filler, and that's wrapped in a Brazilian binder. So a lot of flavor for this one. Again, a nice medium body, nothing overpowering. You still get a lot of flavor with this guy. Just a beautiful stick, very elegant. Perfect for pretty much any time of the day. You could do this one in the morning, afternoon, evening. It's all relevant. So definitely a tasty cigar. And again, this was my number one cigar of the year. So I highly recommend that you guys try it if you have not already. If you have, I'd love to hear the feedback. And as always, I thank you so much for hanging out. And I do wish you a very happy week of smoking. And I'll see you guys next Sunday. Cheers.